Trust your first impression. What do you see?
I see a boat.
I see a boat. Very good. Tell me about this boat.
It looks like a fishing boat.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more. Are you in the boat?
I'm in the boat.
Mm-hmm. Look down at your feet. See if you could see your feet on that boat.
Yeah, I don't have shoes on.
Mm-hmm. Describe your feet for me. What did it look like?
Big.
Big. Mm-hmm.
White.
Mm-hmm.
Your feet.
Are they male or female feet?
Male.
Male. Let's see what you're wearing.
Checkered pants.
Checkered pants. Very good. What else?
T-shirt.
Mm-hmm.
White.
What else?
That's it.
What do you look like?
Mm-hmm. Brown hair.
Mm-hmm.
Blue eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Thin. I'm smoking.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel there?
Early 30s.
Mm-hmm. So what is it that you do on this boat?
I'm working on the boat.
Mm-hmm. What do you do?
Fishing.
Mm-hmm. Is this your boat or somebody else's?
Somebody else's.
Mm-hmm. Do you have any certain responsibilities on this boat?
Fishing.
Mm-hmm.
Cleaning. Taking care of the boat.
Mm-hmm. What do they call you? Mm-hmm. When I call out the name Jim, does that sound like your name?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So Jim, let's see what is that you're doing there today.
We're fishing. But I'm taking a break
mm-hmm.
right now.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Smoking.
Who else is there with you, Jim?
My father.
Mm-hmm. Is this your father's boat?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about your relationship with your father. Do you like working with him?
No.
Mm-hmm.
No, he's mean.
Mm-hmm.
Stern. Rough.
Jim, take a look at his eyes. The eyes are the window to the soul. Does he seem familiar to you?
Yes.
Who is that? Who is that in the life of Samantha?
It's my mom.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So let's see what happens with your father there, Jim. I want you to move to a scene where something important is happening with your father. Where are you?
I'm on the side of the boat.
Mm-hmm. I'm on the side of the boat?
Yeah, on this side, the on the edge, sitting on the edge.
Mm-hmm.
And we're arguing.
Mm-hmm. What's the argument about?
He's just angry because there's not enough fish.
Mm-hmm.
He's just very angry.
What is he telling you?
He's just blaming it on me.
Mm-hmm.
Has nothing to do with me.
So what happens next?
So we
what happens now, Jim?
We start screaming at each other. And he tries to hit me. I lose my balance. And I fall backwards.
What happens to you?
I fall into the ocean.
Can you swim?
No. Not very well.
Mm-hmm. So tell me everything that happens while you're in that ocean.
I'm just panicking and I can't breathe.
You can watch it as an observer. Tell me what happens, Jim.
I see it. I'm looking for the boat. I see it in the distance.
Mm-hmm. Where are you?
I'm in the water.
Mm-hmm. Are you above water or below?
I'm gasping.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm gasping for air. And I'm trying to swim,
mm-hmm.
but I can't.
What's going through your mind, Jim?
I'm panicking. I'm trying to wave my arms. Trying to get him to come back. Help.
What happens?
That's it.
Well, continue. Your life is not over. What happens after that? Where do you go to next? See your body. Follow your body. And tell me what happens to it.
Just moving, moving up.
Tell me everything that you do.
Slowly going up.
Mm-hmm.
But I can still see down.
Can you see your body?
Yes.
How do you feel about your body now?
Relief.
Are you still in the water or outside the water?
I'm outside the water.
So where do you feel?
Floating up. I feel way much better.
Mm-hmm.
A relief.
Can you see your father now?
Yeah.
What happens?
He's just... He's just panicking as well. Mm-hmm. He doesn't know what to do. He's angry, but yet he's worried about me. Mm-hmm. But he knows that something bad happened.
Connect him with him telepathically. Connect with his feelings and see what's going on with him. What's he feeling?
He's feeling conflicted, mm-hmm. sadness, mm-hmm. despair, but also anger. Mm-hmm.
At who?
Just at himself. Mm-hmm. It's like he didn't... He didn't mean for that to happen, but...
But now he has to live with it.
Yes.
Can you forgive him for not knowing any better? I want you to feel his despair, knowing that his anger caused your death. He was out of control. As you go into his body, see what he sees. And go in to see and feel what he feels. And tell me what that feels like.
He hates himself.
So you can see that how he treated you was a mirror to himself.
Yes.
He hated himself.
Yes.
And he just took it out on you.
Yes.
You had nothing to do with it.
Yes.
You were just there. Can you forgive him now? Can you feel pity on him for not knowing?
Yes.
All right, I'm going to put my hand on your chest. And I want you to give me all of those feelings that you've been holding on for so long. Give me all of those feelings of losing your life, not understanding why you had to lose your life. Now you have that knowledge, knowing that he actually hated himself, not you. He just didn't know any better. He didn't know how to handle himself. Feel all of that coming out of you and give it to me. You don't need to hold on to that anymore. Tell me when I have it all. All right, I'm going to take all that and send it to the universe. Now in this space that's vacant, every cell of your body is waiting for something to fill it with. What would you like to fill that with?
Light.
Mm-hmm. Let's fill that with lots of light. Lots of loving light. Feel it coming in. Feel it coming in every single cell of your being. Is being filled with that light. And I'm going to touch your forehead and seal that in. What else would you like to fill it with?
Love.
Lots of love. It's like a fire hose of love, filling all of the spaces. Feel it coming in. Total love. Mm-hmm. How do you feel now? Good. So I'd like for you to continue your journey. Continue your journey up into that light and tell me what happens. Where do you go to next? After you see his boat.
I just keep going up. Mm-hmm. So everything's. I just keep going up and up and up. Mm-hmm.
What do you see along the way?
I just see the the clouds past me.
Mm-hmm.
I just keep going
mm-hmm.
into blackness.
Mm-hmm. What do you see now in that blackness?
Just blackness.
Mm-hmm. How does it feel to be in that blackness? Check in with your body and tell me. What comes into your mind?
I feel at peace.
Mm-hmm.
Feel relieved.
Mm-hmm. So take a while to rest in that blackness, resting from that life. And when you've rested enough, tell me what happens after you've rested. Does anybody come to greet you? Do you go anywhere after that? Feels good to be in that blackness, doesn't it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I want to stay.
Mm-hmm. Stay as long as you wish. And when you've had enough of that blackness, we're going to move on to the time where you meet with your guides and your counsel to talk about the life that you just lived. And tell me what happened. Who do you meet with?
Nancy.
Mm-hmm. Who's Nancy? Mm-hmm. So tell me what she says.
She says everything's gonna be okay.
Mm-hmm. Is Nancy one of your guides? Mm-hmm. So let Nancy tell you about this last life that you lived. What were you supposed to be learning in that life?
She says, she said acceptance.
Mm-hmm. Acceptance. You were supposed to accept your father?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And did you?
No.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything that you learned from that life? Any lessons?
Not really.
Mm-hmm. So what do you have to do next, now that you know that you didn't learn acceptance? What does Nancy say next?
She says I have to go back.
Mm-hmm. How does that make you feel?
I don't want to go back. Feel scared.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out what it is that you're scared of. I want you to go deep inside and find out where those fears come from. What comes to mind?
Monsters.
Mm-hmm. What do these monsters look like?
They're black.
Mm-hmm.
And kind of formless.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
where are they?
Everywhere.
Mm-hmm. And what do these monsters do?
Take energy.
Mm-hmm.
It's like they're kind of like they're black holes.
Mm-hmm.
Sucking energy. They're everywhere.
Mm-hmm. Did Jim encounter these monsters?
No.
Who encountered them?
Jenna.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out who Jenna is. Tell me about Jenna.
A little girl.
Mm-hmm. Let's go back to the life of Jenna. Go drifting and floating to that life. And be there and describe where you are.
I'm in the forest.
Mm-hmm. How old are you, Jenna?
7.
Mm-hmm. Where are you going?
Running, I'm running.
Mm-hmm.
Running through the forest.
What are you running for?
I'm scared.
Mm-hmm. What are you scared of, Jenna?
I can see things.
Mm-hmm. What do you see?
I can see things other people can't see.
Mm-hmm. Tell me what you've seen.
I see the black energy.
The black energy.
The black monsters. The black. The blackness. Chasing me. Trying to consume me.
Mm-hmm. Why you, Jenna? Why do they want to consume you?
Because I'm pure.
Mm-hmm. Do these monsters go after pure energy?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
They feed off of it.
Like children?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Children.
But you know this.
Yes, I can see them. Mm-hmm. Yes, and most people can't see.
Do they talk to you?
No, they just watch me.
Mm-hmm. How do you defend yourself, Jenna?
I just run.
Mm-hmm. Have they ever caught you?
No.
Mm-hmm.
They're always there. They're always there, watching me.
Let's see what happens next, Jenna. Go to the next significant scene in that lifetime.
I'm laying in a bed. I'm sick.
What's wrong with you?
I have a fever. I'm in a very, very old house. It's like a cabin. In the woods. There's, I think it's my mother standing over me. Trying to get me to eat something. She's got her hand on my forehead. And she has a bowl of soup. And I'm not hungry. But I know that I'm sick.
What happens next?
I'm just laying there, not feeling good. But she's trying to help me.
And then?
And a man walks in. I think it's my father. He's got a rifle. A hunting gun. He says he was out hunting and he has a dead animal with him. He comes over to the bed and gives me a kiss.
Take a look at both your parents' eyes and see if you recognize them.
I do. One of them. Yes. There's Nancy again.
What do you see?
Nancy.
Who is Nancy?
It's my grandmother.
Where is she? Who do you recognize? Your mother or father?
My mother. My mother. My father, I don't.
So let's see what happens here. What happens in the scene that's important? Are you left alone?
My mother's sitting beside me.
Okay.
And they're very worried. And she's crying. I'm not feeling good.
Let's see what happens next. You can fast forward it and see what happens. What happens to Jenna?
She's gone.
I'm gone. So what happens after you leave your body, Jenna?
I start moving. It's a really big breath.
Where do you go?
I just go up.
Mm-hmm.
I think the monsters are not gone.
Where are they?
They're around me.
Mm-hmm.
They're around me.
What do you do?
I just try to keep them away from me.
Mm-hmm.
They just won't let go. So they wanna take me somewhere.
Mm-hmm. What do you say?
Say no. They wanna take me somewhere.
Where do you go?
I just feel them pulling at me.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm fighting. And if I am just telling them no, I don't want to go. But they're telling me that I'm not supposed to be here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm supposed to be there. Where they're from.
Uh-huh. What do you think?
I don't know.
I'm confused.
Mm-hmm. I don't know.
So let's see where it is that you go.
Taking me. Taking me to through a tunnel. Through a tunnel.
Mm-hmm.
A long tunnel. It keeps going and going and going and going. If I want to go.
Mm-hmm. So what do you do? Where do you go, Jenna?
To a huge triangle.
Mm-hmm. A huge triangle.
Yes.
That's where they took you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Gigantic.
What's it made out of?
It's made out of some kind of metal.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just a frame. It's just the outside of the triangle. It's hollow inside.
Mm-hmm. And where are you?
Just floating. I'm floating. They're pulling me through that space. And
Uh, What's inside of this triangle? What do you feel?
I feel strangely better.
Mm-hmm.
Like I stopped resisting.
Mm-hmm.
I feel more relaxed and I feel more trusting.
Mm-hmm.
I don't feel scared. But everything is so dark. It's hard to see things.
Mm-hmm.
I see like a land.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Another planet.
Mm-hmm.
It's barren.
Mm-hmm.
I see shapes like buildings. And they tell me that they want me to see it. And there's a lot of fire. A lot of, like, smoke. Like, things have been burned up.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's a wasteland. Like, it's very... Everything's very dark. So everything looks like most things are dead.
Mm-hmm.
There's no life.
Are you on the land or watching it?
Watching it.
Mm-hmm.
I see it from above.
Mm-hmm. What is this place?
It was...
What comes to mind?
It was somewhere I once lived.
Mm-hmm. Let's get the name of this place. Allow the name to come into your mind.
Shala.
Shala?
Shala.
Mm-hmm. Shala.
Shala.
Was your home?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Is this a planet?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Another world?
Mm-hmm.
But it was destroyed?
Mm-hmm. How do you feel that it was destroyed?
Angry.
Mm-hmm.
Sad.
Do you feel that this planet was attacked?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of explosions.
Mm-hmm.
It was completely annihilated.
Mm-hmm. Why are you being shown this planet by these dark forces?
They want me to know that I was once there.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't want me to forget.
Why is that?
They say that I was once, I, Well, they say I belong to them.
Mm-hmm. Belong to who?
To the blackness.
Mm-hmm. Do you believe that? How does it feel?
I don't know.
How does it feel?
It feels okay.
Mm-hmm.
I don't feel as scared anymore.
Mm-hmm. What else did they tell you about this home of yours?
They said that they will get revenge.
Against who?
Against the people that, or the things that did this.
Mm-hmm.
And they will cross all barriers, they will cross all time, they will cross all dimensions. That we cannot forget.
Mm-hmm. What happens next?
They say that they want me to stay there with them.
And where is there?
They're just floating around.
Mm-hmm.
They're just in space. They're just floating. They're formless.
Mm-hmm. Look at yourself and see what you look like.
I'm just a ball of light.
Mm-hmm. Do you look like them?
No.
Mm-hmm. So are you convinced that you are part of them?
I think that...
You're light?
I think that I'm both.
Mm-hmm.
That I'm both at the same time.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel different than them?
Yes, I feel different.
Mm-hmm.
But I also feel a connection to them.
Mm-hmm.
In a strange way.
Mm-hmm.
I feel some sort of, familiarity, or, but I know that I'm not 100% like them.
Mm-hmm.
But I kind of understand them.
Okay, good. So let's see what happens after you leave them and you go back with your counsel. Where are you?
I drop back down, dropping down.
Mm-hmm.
I'm dropping down. Sitting on the floor, cross-legged.
Mm-hmm.
And there are people around me.
What do they look like?
It's just like a bunch of people.
Mm-hmm.
And all different, you know, women, men.
Mm-hmm.
And all different kinds of clothes.
Mm-hmm.
But kind of like tattered.
Mm-hmm.
Clothes.
Tattered, yes.
Like old, tattered.
Mm-hmm.
Clothes. And they all look, they all look weary.
Mm-hmm. What about you? How do you look?
I feel tired.
Mm-hmm. What is this place? What do you do here?
I don't know. very sunny.
It's sunny?
Mm-hmm. Yes, it's very sunny. I see, feel the heat on my body. Mm-hmm. I have hardly any clothes on. Mm-hmm. But I feel the sun, it's beating down on me, and I'm surrounded by these people, this group of people, and they're all staring at me.
What do you look like?
Young. Mm-hmm. Skinny. I feel like a little boy.
Mm-hmm. What do they call you there?
Mike?
Does Mike sound right to you?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So Mike, what are you doing in this area? Where are you?
I'm in the desert. Mm-hmm. I'm searching for something in the sand.
What are you searching for?
Desert. Bits of metal. Mm-hmm. I'm sifting. I'm looking through it.
Mm-hmm. Mike, do you feel like you're in modern times or ancient times?
Oh, ancient. Mm-hmm. Yeah, ancient. Ancient.
Mm-hmm. What year comes to mind?
It's 2000?
Mm-hmm. The year 2000?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more. What happens?
They're telling me to keep working, keep looking. The men surrounding me, telling me to keep working. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. How old do you feel there, Mike?
12.
Mm-hmm. Are they looking for it, or just you?
No, they're just staring at me while I'm doing it. Mm-hmm. Like, I have to do it. And they don't have to do anything. They can just watch.
What do you feel that you do there? Is it something special that you do only?
I'm just really I seem to find things easier than everybody else. Mm-hmm. So I just have an ability to find things quickly and easily.
Mm-hmm. So let's fast forward and see what it is that you find.
See a disc.
Mm-hmm. How big is this disc?
Not the size of a plate. Mm-hmm. It's gold. Mm-hmm. It's beautiful.
Does it have anything on there? Any engravings?
Yes.
What does it look like?
It has a lot of pictographs. Mm-hmm. Writing. Mm-hmm. The pictures.
Can you tell what they mean, Mike?
Yes, I can read them.
Mm-hmm. What does it say?
I'm talking about it's a story about the person who discovered that the land. It's just a story. It's a story how he discovered the land. That's it.
And was that this put there on purpose? Buried there?
It was lost.
It was lost.
It was a lost artifact.
Okay.
If the people had been looking for it for a long time. And they are the only one that could find it.
What's going to happen now, Mike, with that artifact?
I have to go place it somewhere.
Okay.
I have to go put it inside a specific structure. It's kind of like a key. Has to be inserted into something else to unlock something.
So let's go find out where it is that you place this artifact. See yourself there now. What does this look like?
It's a pyramid. I have to put it underneath the pyramid.
Underneath the pyramid? How do you get there?
I have to dig. There's a special place for it.
Yes.
And I have to find it. I have to dig. I have to find it.
How do you know where to dig?
I just know. I just know. Something tells me. There's something that tells me and it speaks to me. It tells me where I misplace it.
So see yourself fast-forwarding through that and finding the place where you need to place this artifact. What is it?
It's just a small little space underneath, like a crawl space underneath the pyramid. And there's just a perfect circular indentation where it needs to be placed. It fits perfectly, and I'm supposed to place it there. And it will unlock something.
Let's find out what it is.
I feel scared though.
Tell me what's scaring you about this. You came all this way to do it. What do you do?
I'm scared. I just feel scared. I don't know.
What is this fear coming from? Is it coming from in you or coming from outside of you? Let's pinpoint where this fear is coming from.
It's coming inside, from inside of you.
Mm-hmm. What is it that you're afraid of?
Afraid of what's going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
Afraid of the consequences.
Mm-hmm.
I'm afraid of what it will unleash.
Mm-hmm. So go ahead and do what you need to do, Mike. What do you do?
I decide not to do it.
Mm-hmm.
And I take it. And I start running. Because I'm just taking it, I'm going to keep it for myself. Even though I know that they're going to come after me.
Mm-hmm. Who's going to come after you?
The man. The man that I'm working for.
Mm-hmm.
I'm running, holding it, trying to decide where to go, what to do with it. I'm not going to place it where it needs to be placed. I don't want to.
So let's see the outcome of this. I want you to fast forward to see what eventually happens.
They find me. They for the men find me.
Were you hiding?
Yes, I was hiding in a cave.
Mm-hmm.
I was hiding in a cave.
With the artifact?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And they come here, they find me, someone sees me there, knows I'm there. They call everybody else, all the other men that are chasing me and hunting me. They see me. And I don't have any defenses.
Look at all of those men. Look into their eyes and see if you recognize any of them.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Who do you recognize? Mm-hmm. And who is this man in that life? What does he want from you?
He wants me to place the artifact in the specific place to unlock
mm-hmm.
the code.
Mm-hmm.
To unleash the evil spirits,
mm-hmm.
demons.
Mm-hmm. Are they locked away in the pyramid?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Underneath.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the key.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't want to do it. And that they're going to kill me.
Are you the only one who can do it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. But if they kill you, no one gets to do it.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. So what happens?
Okay. I try to take it from me.
Mm-hmm.
And then I have swords. So then my hand,
mm-hmm,
it's cut. My wrist.
They cut your hand off?
Cut through my hand.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And crying. And they're yelling. So they take it. They take it from me.
Mm-hmm. What happens to you?
I just lay down. I'm feeling, you know, just laying on the ground.
Mm-hmm. You can use this. You view this scene as an observer. You don't have to feel any discomfort. Tell me what happens to you.
They just start cutting my body in pieces.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel as you're watching this?
I feel disconnected.
Mm-hmm.
I'm watching it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't feel any pain.
Mm-hmm. So what happens to you after you leave that body? And what do they do with that, with the pieces?
They try to find someone else,
mm-hmm,
like me,
mm-hmm,
but I was unique.
Mm-hmm.
They can't. They're searching to find someone who can do it. So they have to have a specific type of person place it for it to work.
Mm-hmm. What was special about you, Mike? What powers did you have?
I can see. I can. I could hear. I could hear. I could hear spirits. Mm-hmm. I could hear. I could see the future.
Yes.
Could heal.
Mm-hmm. You were very special.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So what happens to your soul after you leave? Where do you go?
I go up.
Mm-hmm.
Up. I go up.
Does anybody greet you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Who's there?
My other, my Mimi, Mary.
Mm-hmm.
My other grandmother.
Mm-hmm. What does she tell you?
She says it's gonna be okay. So everything's gonna be okay.
What were the lessons in that lifetime? What were you supposed to do there?
I was supposed to be brave.
Mm-hmm. Were you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You didn't unleash the evil spirits.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. You gave your life up for that.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. But you didn't actually give up your life, did you?
No.
You just gave up that body.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So what did you learn about yourself in that life?
I'm strong.
Mm-hmm. No matter who attacks you.
No matter who, yes. Mm-hmm. No matter who attacks me, that I'm strong and I can get through anything.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So I'd like you to leave that scene now and go with Mimi.
Yeah.
And let's find out what is the reason that you chose the life of Samantha. Go to the time when you're sitting with your guides discussing what lessons need to be learned in the life of Samantha. Where are you?
I just see crystals everywhere. I see, mm-hmm. I'm like a crystal cave.
Mm-hmm.
And it's white, like, you know, just white crystal, mm-hmm. clear crystal.
Yes.
And I'm sitting down.
Is there a place to sit there?
Yeah, there's a crystal seat.
Mm-hmm.
Everything's made of crystal.
Mm-hmm. Are you alone, or are there others there?
Yeah, there's a few other people, but I don't know who they are.
Mm-hmm.
They're just...
How do they look?
They're not really people.
Mm-hmm.
They don't look like people.
What do they look like?
They look like... They look like water.
Mm-hmm.
They look like moving water.
Moving water, yes.
Shimmering.
Mm-hmm. But you can talk.
Yes, I can talk to them.
So what's the conversation today in the crystal cave about?
My life.
Mm-hmm. What are they telling you?
They say, even though I don't want to, I have to go back again.
Mm-hmm.
And... They say... They say, I have to... The reason that I need to go back is I have to conquer all my fears.
Mm-hmm. Where are these fears coming from?
They say that I don't... They say that I need to learn to use all of my gifts, and I cannot, and I have to learn how to get through the fear.
Mm-hmm.
The fear is just, they said that I know, they said it's harder for me, and I'm more afraid because I know more than maybe others know right now.
Mm-hmm. Like Jenna and Mike.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell her some more about why she's here? She seems to have seen Shala.
She's here. She's here because she has a unique perspective.
Mm-hmm. What perspective is that?
She can see both the dark and the light.
Mm-hmm.
And she can draw from both.
Okay.
To benefit. To benefit everyone.
Okay. But it seems that these fears are not allowing her to do this.
Yes.
Okay. So we can work on that beginning today to eliminate those fears.
Yes.
Good. We saw the planet Shala. Is that where she's actually from?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell me a little bit about that place?
It was a very, very beautiful place at one time.
Mm-hmm.
And very lush, full of life.
Mm-hmm.
Full of full of happiness. And then it was taken over.
Who took it over?
These green things.
Mm-hmm. Green beings?
Yes, green beings.
Mm-hmm. What do they look like?
They look like frogs.
Like frogs. Mm-hmm. What did they want with this planet?
They wanted to take it over. They wanted to, you know, conquest.
Mm-hmm. So what did they do to the planet?
They used their weapons.
Mm-hmm.
And destroyed it almost instantly, because they wanted to clear everything off of it so they could build what they wanted to.
Mm-hmm. Was she there when this happened? Did she live
yes.
there?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So what is she carrying over? What fears are she carrying it over from there?
Of total destruction.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Total destruction.
Was there anybody from her family in that place, or just her?
Just her.
All right. So, can we disconnect from that planet so that she doesn't have that fear anymore of total destruction? It seems to me that life is still bleeding into this one. Can we sever that one so that she doesn't carry that fear? She only carries the memory of it, but not the destruction.
Okay.
Thank you very much. What's the symbols that she sees all the time in meditation?
They have to do with her old have to do with the other planet.
Mm-hmm. Shala?
Her old world.
Mm-hmm. What are the symbols telling her?
Just a reminder that she will always have that she will always have that connection to that, to those entities that she was with.
The dark ones?
The dark ones and the light ones.
Okay. Good. So it's nothing to be concerned with?
No.
It's just a reminder.
It's a reminder, and it's a tool.
Okay, good. How can she move forward now, knowing what she knows?
She doesn't have to be afraid.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the only thing stopping her.
Mm-hmm. Stop being afraid of what she needs to do?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. She's gotta to make a decision now about which way to go.
Yes.
What would you recommend?
To do what's in her heart.
Okay.
What she wants to do.
Mm-hmm.
And don't let the fear stop her.
Mm-hmm. Is she on the right path of what she's doing now?
Yes, as long as she can get through the fears,
mm-hmm.
then everything will work out beautifully.
Very good. So she's doing exactly what she needs to be doing.
Yes.
But she's procrastinating a lot.
Yes.
Why is that?
Because she's scared.
Mm-hmm. Can you physically, can you give her a physical description of what this fear looks like that's holding her down?
It's a big, mm-hmm. big rock.
A big rock. And where is this rock?
On her, it's like a boulder mm-hmm. on her chest and stomach.
And chest and stomach. Would you allow me to assist in removing that today?
Yes.
All right. So, Samantha, I want you to see this boulder in front of you. And tell me how it feels to have this boulder.
Bad. Mm-hmm. Heavy.
Heavy. All right. So I'm going to allow you to find a tool to destroy this boulder. I want you to go through your whole arsenal of things. What would you like to use to destroy this boulder today?
A big sledgehammer.
All right. So you see yourself putting on those goggles, taking that sledgehammer, and I want you to start chomping away at this boulder. And tell me exactly what you're doing as you're doing this.
Just hitting it as hard as I can.
Mm-hmm. What's happening to it?
It's going into a million pieces.
Mm-hmm. Keep pulverizing it. And as you do, feel the difference in your body.
Lighter.
Mm-hmm. We don't want to leave any of those pieces around. Go ahead and either grab a shop vac or something and let's just start removing all of those shards and pieces that have been pulverized. I want you to clean it all up. Don't leave anything behind. Just use your breath. Feel that lightness again. And let me know now that you have no boulder on you. How does that feel?
Feels good.
Mm-hmm.
I can get breathe.
You can breathe again.
Yes.
Would you do a body scan on her, please, to check her health? And tell me what you find.
I all of her complaints will go mm-hmm. away if she continues with the meditation.
Mm-hmm. Is this the best way to raise her vibration?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And would you begin today to get her circulation moving now that that boulder is not on top of her?
Yes.
Thank you very much. Is there anything that I could have asked that I didn't that you would like to tell her today?
Just to follow through.
To follow through. Very good. Thank you so much. Are we complete today?
Yes.
Thank you.
Wow.
Thanks. You're selenite. How long do you feel you're on this journey?
How long?
Yeah. How long did it feel?
An hour?
About an hour and 40 minutes.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What'd you think?
Pretty intense. Yeah.
Did you learn a lot about yourself?
Yes. Really
a lot bigger
interesting.
Than you thought you were, huh?
Yeah.
What did you see as an image of what you look like? It sounded huge to me.
I just saw a very just light,
mm-hmm.
you know, just
huge,
light spreading
huge,
out.
Yeah.
Huge,
yeah.
Just
beautiful.
Like a
big angel
column of, you know, that
powerful.
You couldn't even see the
wow.
The you know edges.
So how do you feel?
I feel good, yeah.
You think this was a success?
I do.
Wonderful. So in the next 3 days, you're going to be wide open. You're going to be receiving more and more stuff when you least expect it.
Yeah.
And now you have a word and a gesture to use to
yes.
trigger this sensation again.
Yes.
How does that feel?
Good.
Good.
Good, yeah.
So I know you don't want to share it. I know it was a beautiful session. What do you think?
Ooh. I just don't want a video. I don't mind if you share it otherwise, but I just mm-hmm. don't. I just don't make it.
What do we think if we diffuse your face?
Oh, you could do that.
So you can't see who you are?
You put like a...
Yeah, it's a shield over it, so you don't see it. How would you like that? Because I thought it was a really incredible session. But you walked in here saying, no video, so...
Yeah.
But, I mean, we could cover your face like I have with others. They can't even tell you who you are. We can, you know, none of these videos go out unedited.
Yeah.
If you feel that this is something that other people would benefit from, we can always cut out the parts that we talk about, all this stuff. There are some videos I don't even put anything in about the higher self, any answers. So we can do
okay.
just the parts where we see people. You know, you recognize them, but that doesn't mean anything.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. One thing that I wanted to do
yeah.
that I didn't do, and I think we should do it before we go back. I want to put you down again real fast because there's something really important we need to do. You'd be willing to do it?
Sure.
All right. So feel yourself going down again. Keep going. Deeper and deeper. I want you to go back to where you left your body. All dismembered. Find yourself back there as Mike, seeing all of the pieces of your body. Can you see it?
Yes.
All right. I want you to put all of those pieces together. Find every piece of your body and put it back together. Every bit of it. All the legs, the torso, the hands. Put it back.
Yes.
How does that feel?
Feels good.
Mm-hmm. All right. So now that you feel whole again, I want you to see how that feels differently in your body. How does that make your body feel?
Complete.
Wonderful. Come back very quickly now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Eyes open. Nice, huh?
Yes.
That was what was missing.
Yes. Yeah. Very nice.
It was almost like you were missing parts of you.
Yeah. Yeah. That's mm-hmm. true. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. Yeah. So let's disconnect you.
Okay.
Oh. And let's say goodbye.
Okay.
Past life regression.
Yes.
Yes. So what was the reason you came here?
Many reasons.
What's the main reason?
Mostly because I was curious about past lives.
Yeah. So you've seen quite a few past lives today.
Yes.
Oh my God. Which was yes. the one that was the most, like, gave you the yeah, most impression?
Probably on the boat.
Yeah.
Yes. That was the most intense. Yeah.
And that was like fear of dying.
Yes.
And you saw that you went straight up and
yes.
your grandmother was there.
Yes.
And yeah. what do you feel now? How does that change the way you feel?
I feel relief.
Yeah.
Confirmation of what I kind of already knew.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And what we did during the session, which was not shown, it's edited out, is we did a bit of hypnotherapy, so we can do some self-empowerment. How do you feel about those exercises?
It was wonderful.
Yeah.
You'd have to come
here to get that, but you can't see it. Those are my secrets. But we could do a nice self-empowerment,
yes.
So you can actually bring back that feeling that of feeling great.
Yes, I'm
during
excited
the session.
To use the tools.
Excellent. So do you recommend this to other people?
Definitely.
How did 100%. You find out about this?
I was just learning about Dolores Cannon and then did some research on the QHHT therapy
mm-hmm.
and found Alba. So.
Yes. And we did not do QHHT today, but it really was a beautiful session. And you didn't come from very far.
No.
Like other people.
No. Not too far.
But how did it feel? Because, you know, a lot of people come here and they say, you know, I don't think I could be hypnotized.
Well, I didn't think that I could be hypnotized, but I was still open to the possibility.
Mm-hmm.
So.
When did you know you were hypnotized?
As soon as you did the...
The exercise?
Yeah, the exercise.
You're up.
Yeah, that... proved it to me for sure.
Excellent.
Yeah.
So if you would like a session with me, I'm in Miami and I also travel around the country. You can go to my website, albaweinman.com, and you could have a session with me. So thank you very much for watching. Until the next time. Bye.
Excellent.
I'm not going to be in the movie, but
give me a hug.